Hey guys, Ty and Sky here from Ty and Sky's Health Pub, and we are looking for the health topics that matter to you. Follow the link to submit your ideas and we'll get them covered as soon as possible.
Have a good one. Hello, everybody. My name is Tyler, and I'm here with Allison today on childhood healthcare issues. So thank you for joining me today, Allison. And I'd just like to ask you just a few questions specifically about childhood injuries. So if we could start out, what are the major causes of childhood injuries here in the United States?
Really, if we look at all age groups to the age of 24 and look at the leading cause of death, we'll see that motor vehicle accidents are the leading cause. And some of the other leading causes are poisoning, and then also some pedestrian accidents for young people.
Okay. And so poisonings, motor vehicle accidents, those seem to top the list as far as what is causing children to become injured. So I guess to kind of ask a follow-up question based on that, if we look at which of these injuries actually lead to death, what are the injuries that most likely lead to death for children in these different age groups?
Motor vehicle accidents, car accidents are definitely responsible for taking the most lives amongst our children and folks up to 24 years old. We see that the death toll has decreased since we implemented, seat belts and have implemented car seat safety. We've made some really big headway, and so those things definitely do matter, but it still is a leading cause of death for young people. And young people, of course, they don't tend to die from chronic diseases as often and that type of thing. So those are certainly things to consider.
Well, and I think you may bring up a very interesting point there. So we have made strides in certain areas of actually making this less and less of a problem. And you mentioned a few dealing with like car seat safety and seatbelt safety and other things like that. Are there any other kind of safety, maybe measures that are being considered that may help that haven't been implemented yet?
One of the things that I'd like to mention for onto that too is just that the poison control hotline is very helpful, and that information is beneficial to get out there. And also bicycle safety helmets are really important. But one of the simple things that we can do, and definitely is within reach of all families, is modeling safety behavior. I think that we can give out bicycle helmets to children as much as we want. We can hand out bicycle helmets, we can hand out car seats, but unless we're modeling those behaviors and using those behaviors in daily life so that kids are seeing them, and even new parents are seeing it and really making that the norm, I think it's gonna be, we're still not gonna make the impact.
Perfect. So you're talking about kind of as a society, we as individuals can set the bar for kind of childhood safety by just being good models of that safety ourselves.
Absolutely. I think that's the coolest thing to kid. I mean, one of the things that one of my colleagues was telling me about is she's a nurse that works at a local school, and the kids love to run up to her and tell her about how they wore their safety helmet because she would ride her bike and wear a safety helmet to school every day. So that's really, was really cool. But one of the other things that I think is important to think about is how much impact we can have just with very few resources, implementing safety measures such as supervision, making sure that we're just really, watching those little guys. We're really keeping medications and anything that the contents could be potentially harmful out of reach, and out of crawling reach as well. So just some really simple things that I think can make a huge difference at a population level, or we may not save everybody, but it, across the United States, it will make a difference, and we'll see fewer lives lost. So.
Okay, so maybe thinking of these things beforehand, before the injuries happen, and kind of working to prevent those from happening. Very cool. Well, thank you. Thank you, Allison, for joining us today. We had a wonderful talk here about childhood injuries and kind of what can go into preventing death and preventing further injuries amongst children. So thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Hello, Ty and Sky from Ty and Sky's Health Pub here. Are you an event organizer looking for a way to take your event to the next level? Well, we also do live podcast events with real health experts about the health topics that matter to your community. If you're interested in having us come out, follow the link and let us know.
Have a good one.